What's up, chickies? It's Baron here. Today we're going to be doing a Should You Buy on the Redeemer. I know I've done one of these in the past, but the ship has changed. A lot of things have changed, so I want to do it again and just give you a little bit of a revisit and a few little updates and just some things I've been thinking about lately. So before we get into it, I want you to know that we are doing a giveaway on my Thrustmaster T16,000 sticks that I don't really need anymore. All you have to do is comment hashtag sticks in whatever you're going to be commenting, and when we hit 8,000 subscribers, I'll be giving them away to one of you guys that have done that hashtag sticks. So another one is that once we hit 10,000 subs, I'm going to try and do another giveaway and contact Monster Tech Mounts again and try and get some mounts to give away to you guys. So hopefully that will be something that I can do in the future, but you know, it's all in good relative time. But now we're going to get into the video about this ship. Now, I know a lot of things have changed with this ship. Well, not really a lot of things, but some things have actually changed with this. So we're going to do a revisit on or not whether or not you should buy it. I did a video a while ago, like I said. We know that this was going to be a drop ship in Squadron 42, but now it is not going to be the case. It is going to be a dedicated gunship, which it always has been, but it did have that drop ship functionality, and it does have a few other functionalities, which a lot of people don't know about, but if you have watched the deep dive, then you will know that those functionalities that I'll be talking about have, you know, they're going to be quite big. They're going to be a good big thing on this. So if you haven't seen the deep dive video, that's in the cards and in the description. So going from what I've learnt on this ship, it's going to be a beast. It may actually be better than the Hammerhead given its size and firepower. Now, for the price that you can pick this up is ridiculous. Now, saying that, I've had a look at some other ships and prices where we'll go over later, but hoping that it comes out soon, maybe at IAE, you'll definitely see a price hike. Now, again, we will touch on that later, but you will be very curious to see what I've come up with, and I know I'm still curious about coming to the assumption that I have. So, you know, just saying that statement makes you curious, doesn't it? So, with the Redeemer, we know it's grown in size. We know that it was Invictus, and that they had it on display. Now, you also see it in the new IAE trailer, and the size of it is, let's just say it's interesting, because the guy, Jack, standing in front of it is quite, you know, a regular sized person standing in front of the Redeemer when it flies up behind him. So going from that, it's going to be quite a large ship, but we're going to go over the components. It has one size 2 radar, 2 times size 2 computers, 1 times size 3 power plants, 1 times size 3 coolers, 1 times size 3 shield generators. It has 2 times size 2 fuel intakes, 2 times size 2 fuel tanks, 1 times size 2 quantum drive, 1 times size 2 jump drive, and 1 times size 2 quantum fuel tank. Going from the weapons, it has 2 times size 4 pilot controlled C788s, so I'm going to guess they will be able to go to an energy weapon as well. You have 2 times size 6 Manda turrets, which are then 4 size 5 deadbolt cannons. That was a manned turret. On the remote turret, you have 2 times size 4 or 5, which are 4 times size 3 M5A laser autocannons, so I'm going to guess they can be changed as well. And from there, you have 2 times size 4 integrated missile racks, which is 16 size 2s, and then from there, you have 1 size 1 DEFCON noise launcher, and then a 1 size 1 DEFCON decoy launcher also. So with the interior, it also consists of a cockpit. Behind there are 2 remote control turret seats. It has a cruise quarters with either 4 or 5 beds. In there is a size 5 turret entry to the top. The old engine room has the size 5 turret entry for the bottom of the nose. There is a ladder connection from the top module down to the bottom module, so both those rooms are actually modular, and it's very interesting to see some of the modules that they do intend to bring out, because they do talk about it in the LEAP goals, or the funding goals, which is very interesting to see what this ship is going to entail. So going from there to the top to the bottom, you know, which is a component room, as for anything else, it's a little difficult. That was from an image that John Crew had posted in response to a thread called Redeeming the Redeemer. So if you have a look at for that thread, you'll see what I mean. But you know, a lot of these modules that this ship's going to have are going to be very useful. So I don't know if they would be directly related to this vessel, but they do explain in detail what these modules will be able to do, and it does sound like they are talking about the Redeemer in terms of that. So if you don't have one, I would definitely suggest looking into getting one. I don't know how much it's going to go up in price once it's out. Obviously, if you have a look at the Prowler is $440. I do not see the value of $440 there when this ship is $250, when the Merchantman was $450. $450. So there was a $10 difference between the Prowler and the Merchantman. Now, obviously the Merchantman has gone up, but the Prowler is still sitting at $440. How do you even... If anyone knows why it is that expensive, let me know down in the comments, because honestly, I do not see the applicable uses or, you know, any real value in this ship there, other than it's a dropship and it does have its Sukrons on it. So that's all I see in that vessel. Like I said, we go off like just the applicable uses and what they can do and how many like unapplicable uses that they would have as well. But, you know, it's just so weird to see that ship for such a high price when you have a look at the Redeemer and it's so much more capable and so many more better capabilities and just characteristics to the ship itself. I don't know what it is about the Prowler, why it's so expensive. Can someone let me know? That's really, you know, bugging me a little bit. But we're going to go back into the Redeemer, and you know, if you were to get this ship, I would not think that anyone would regret it. You would enjoy this ship once it is out. But again, you know, not everyone is going to be spending that much money. You will be able to possibly do it as an in-game purchase later on when it does become available. So just think about that. It may become available for in-game purchase, but then again, it may not. I'm not 100% sure on this ship, but one can only assume. But I do love this ship. I do think it will be something worth adding to your fleet. But that's been Baron. I'll see you in the verse.